Hello everyone, I'm Professor Nirav Mehta from LG Institute of Technology and Engineering. Today we are going to discuss about subject called Automobile System Design, in which today's topic is to learn about braking of a vehicle. And this braking of a vehicle will contain how your braking effort or braking force will directly affect the motion of your vehicle. Ultimately, in this session, we're going to discuss about how your braking or braking effort and braking efficiency and ultimately those braking element will going to work on your vehicle. So while braking the vehicle, we have 4 points to brake in case of four wheelers. Here there are 2 points of a braking on a front wheel and 2 in a rear. While braking this vehicle, there are several factors which affects the motion of a vehicle and ultimately is directly creates or directly depend on stopping distance. In one, the most important point is center of gravity of our vehicle. So how your center of gravity will work? When you applied your brake to the front axle or a rear axle, the center of gravity will try to turn around those braking points. And ultimately, it will create moment in your system or in your vehicle. Second thing, your wheel track and wheel base of a vehicle. So these three, or you can also consider the clearance or height of a vehicle in same case. So ultimately, these three or four factors which are directly affecting the output condition for your vehicle. So first of all, before discussing this braking of a vehicle technically, let's discuss about minimum stopping distance, or you also can say that minimum safe stopping distance. First of all, what is stopping distance? Stopping distance is that while you are applying brake, the distance covered by your vehicle after applying that brake and ultimately that minimum distance at which you can have your control of a vehicle in hands of a driver, means the stopping distance, it should be that minimum. It should provide safe operation of braking, or with it shouldn't be a turning movement or any kind of movement in your vehicle while applying brake. Clear? If the braking distance is more than that minimum distance, you are going to be safe. But if it is low, less than that, then it could be a possible case of movement, or you can say pitching, yawing, or anything in the case of braking. So here in this particular video, we will going to discuss about how these factors, clear, this braking and ultimately this moment will going to work upon your vehicle, and ultimately then we will determine the stopping distance for your vehicle. So let's consider this. When we are applying brake, front or a rear axle, this tends to stop. If I am applying the brake on only a front wheel, then when the front wheel stops, the moment around that front axle will going to be zero, but it will create moment. It will create your moment through the CG as well as from the rear axle. Why CG? CG is center of gravity of a body where your weight is concentrated. And rear axle is free, so it will try to turn around your front axle. Second thing, in the case of front axle and rear axle, the distribution of effort will going to be different. In the case of front axle, it is always going to be more effort compared to less rear wheel. So you have to consider according to or design your braking system according to that. When you are apply rear wheel axle or braking to the rear wheel axle only, the moment will create it through front wheel and your CG. At the same time, this moment will be predominantly considered from the front wheel when you are at a gradient, or you are climbing, or your vehicle is climbing the slope. At the same time, when you are descending from the slope, we are considering that moment from the rear wheel comparatively greater influential than the CG. But when you are going, it is in a normal case, when you are going on a flat plane, only a front wheel motion or a rear wheel motion, the main major criteria to discuss about is CG. Let's have this mechanism and the distribution of weight in a generalized case. This is an example of a generalized case where a vehicle is ascending to the slope, and in which you can see that vehicle is going upward. The weight of a vehicle at that bank, or you can say angled slope, which has angle of alpha. Here you can see the angle alpha, where its weight is going through this center of gravity, which is CG, and which is making angle with its own central axis, which is alpha. Here you can see the angle which is made by this is mg. This is weight. One is vertical component and one is horizontal component. Vertical component for this weight is mg cos alpha, horizontal is mg sin alpha. This both the component will going to decide how your vehicle going to behave when you are ascending or descending, because ultimately these two forces will going to create either supporting force or either opposing force. Here you have that inertia force, which is called MA. Ultimately, this inertia force is pushed by your engine, and as well as at the same time, you will have a frictional force, clear, which is always going to oppose the motion of a vehicle. Here, L is a distance between two axle, and this is point A and point B for front wheel for point A and rear wheel for point B, and through which the reaction of this force, which is mg sin theta, is created at RA and RB. I hope you understand this all the point. Here, mg sin theta is compensated by MA, mg cos theta is compensated by RB and RA, and the height of the CG is H. I hope you understand the mechanism behind when, and we are considering this generalized case rather than any special case. Clear? Generalized case if I am considering only a car is going with a straight path, then you can have this alpha is equal to zero. Clear? Then we will not going to have any kind of horizontal or vertical component. When it is descending, our MA will be in opposite direction than right now in the place. Clear? I hope you understand mechanism behind this particular diagram and are braking. Now let's discuss about the energy which is possessed by your vehicle while going in the direction. So energy is possessed by, which is kinetic energy, clear, which will be represented by the vehicle weight, clear, initial velocity, final velocity, mass of a vehicle which we are considering, and our gravitational force, which is 1/2 alpha v square, or you can say 1/2 w by g into u square minus v square, which is nothing but representing 1/2 mv square. So kinetic energy here in the case of any vehicle which is going with any speed, or kinetic possessed by a vehicle while going from speed from u to v, which is 1/2 mv square, and here it is represented by 1/2 w by g into u square minus v square. I hope you understand this point. Here w by g is nothing but the mass of a vehicle, w is the weight, and g is a gravitational acceleration or gravitational pull. Here u is initial velocity and v is the final velocity. In when the brake applied in the vehicle stops, velocity v will always become zero. Clear? Here when we are decelerating and we are accelerating, what are the different type of weight will occur? When we are accelerating, which is wt is equal to mu h upon b into vw, where b is wheelbase, w is nothing but the weight of a vehicle, mu is a coefficient of friction, and h is nothing but height of cg. Clear? This is representing. What is this representing? This is this both. Let's consider this. When you are going upward the motion, then resultant acceleration will be affected by gravitational pull, and which will try to stop your motion. Clear? But when you are descending from the slope, it is always going to help you to have that pull force while going downward. Clear? So here you can see that when we are accelerating or we are ascending, clear, which is mu h upon b into w, which is affected by our base and the height of cg from the ground. when we are deaccelerating, when we are deaccelerating, it is multiplied by our deacceleration of the vehicle, and which is affected and which is the fraction part of our gravitational pull. I hope you got this point, when we are accelerating and when we are deaccelerating. So this was the concept about what we are going to do in our case, when we are considering generalized case, which is considering by going upward towards our slope. The next point, what is the stopping distance in the case of our vehicle? It is a classical mechanics equation, which is nothing but S is equals to ut plus 1/2 at square. Here a is represented by small f, u is u, t here is time. So ultimately stopping distance, which is S is equals to ut plus 1/2 at square, as well as it will be represented by v square minus u square is equal to 2as. These equations are nothing but the equation of uniform acceleration equation, and this equation will directly going to apply to find out the stopping distance of vehicle. In this case, this F will be founded with the help of this equation of when we are ascending or descending the ground of a vehicle. So ultimately we have to find this acceleration or deacceleration. If it is the case of our vehicle is stopping, clear, then the acceleration is found from that equation, and ultimately this equation will be put into this particular uniform velocity or uniform velocity equation or uniform acceleration equation, where we can find the minimum stopping distance, which is S is equals to ut plus 1 half at square, and v square minus u square is equal to 2as. So this is how you can find the stopping distance. But when we are braking the vehicle, it is not only the classical mechanics case, but as well as it will create moment from your CG to the front wheel and rear. So now all we have to find is what the reaction, because to nullify that moment, we have to generate opposite moment, clear, by means of our geometry of a vehicle. So the moment generated by brake will be nullified or will be balanced. So here we are going to find what amount of moment will going to generate at our front wheel and rear wheel while braking, only front wheel, rear wheel and forward wheel. So ultimately here in next session or next topic, we are going to discuss about this braking of a vehicle or a stopping of a vehicle by balancing this moments. Clear? So let's get into this. Here we can see the motion. Here we can see the motion of the vehicle in a particular direction, where our inertia force, here it is making angle for that is theta with the ground. So our CG will be through this, which is W, and which has two components. One is W cos theta and W sin theta.